many of the bugs in cow effluent can cause mastitis. The longer and closer the proximity of the cow is to effluent, the higher the risk that she may get mastitis.
When they lie down on the beds, they'll lie down naturally with their feet tucked up and curled underneath them in contact with the udder. Cow effluent carries a whole heap of bacteria, and many of these bacteria can cause mastitis in the cow. And the close contact between the effluent brings the bacteria into proximity with the teat end. The bacteria then can colonise that teat end, and then in the time in between milkings can potentially grow up into the udder and cause an infection. Alternatively, these bacteria can be transported with the cow into the milking shed, and then at milking they can get into the milk, causing coliform counts and milk quality issues, or they can, with back flushing, if air gets into the milk line, they can be injected back into the udder and cause mastitis infections that way. We know from overseas work and from work within New Zealand that many of the infections that cows get at calving in terms of mastitis and immediately after calving are actually picked up in the dry period. So contamination of cows' teats and udders during the dry period is a really high risk for later on mastitis. Keeping those cows clean in the early and late part of the dry period is particularly important because those are the key risk times for cows to pick up new infections. The types of mastitis that you see in house systems are predominantly environmental mastitises because the infection is coming from the environment that the cow is living in. The major source of that infection is often the faeces of the cow in that environment, and so close contact between cow and faeces increases that risk, and this is why dirty cows are such an issue. Environmental mastitises can be very severe and life-threatening in some cases, and they can also be an ongoing clinical mastitis issue in the main part of lactation. With all these things, there are treatment and health costs and welfare issues as well. Cleanliness is important, but it's not just cleanliness on its own. Beds need to be clean and dry to minimise the risk of mastitis. Beds can become wet from faeces being traipsed onto the back of them from the cow's hooves, but they can also pick up moisture from condensation, especially in single skin buildings, and from rain if it blows in. This is a particular problem at the end of buildings or in open-sided buildings. Milk leaking from cows can be a further issue and contaminates the bed right where the udder is, and so is a direct risk. Dirty teats are a real risk factor for milk quality and coliform counts in the bulk tank. Contaminated teats at milking carry the bacteria into the milking process, and these bacteria can be flushed into the bulk tank. After milking, a cow's teat should be clean and fully covered with teat spray. In that situation, you might think it's not at much risk, but the sad truth is most teat sprays don't actually last for that long, and certainly none of them really last all the way between twice daily milkings. Also, most teat sprays really struggle if the surface they're trying to clean is itself contaminated. So contamination of teat ends in between milkings becomes a real risk for picking up mastitis.